welcome, one and all. I am a very unusual tree. In my 200 years, I have developed some human tendencies, like judgment, a smart mouth, and mood swings. Now, Ozzie Braw, my self-appointed caregiver, he thinks I have a heart and soul. Oh, here he comes. Pretend you didn't hear me.
How are you feeling, my lady? A little down? Me too. But I'm sure we'll both feel better soon. I called on our new tree doctor in town. A lady. Oh, relax. I'll make sure she's gentle.
Hello, Mr. Braw. I'm Dr. Jan Lin.
Good to meet you.
How's the old gal doing?
Not so good. To tell you the truth, Doc, she's a little down, but you calling her old doesn't help. Being a woman, you can understand that.
What?
You need to understand that my family has had charge of this tree for many years. In fact, her bicentennial birthday is coming right up. It's also been established, with much evidence, that when this tree is not asleep, it can hear and understand everything. So we have to be careful when we're around her.
Well, sir, it looks like your good care has paid off. I'm sure she's got some fine years left, and I'm pretty sure she's going to outlive the both of us. However, you mentioned on the phone that she had some roots that had pushed up through the ground before, requiring surgery. But everything looks fine now.
Hello, sweetheart. Oh, I missed you too. You're writing, you're learning a poem? Oh, for Lady Oak. That's wonderful. Let's hear it. Oh, that's great, Gabby. Oh, did you know that the man who wrote that poem was Joyce Kilmer? A man. Yeah. Oh, the last line of the poem? Oh, it was, poems are made by fools like me, but only God can make a tree. Yeah. Well, it would be great if you had it memorized by Christmas. Okay. Oh, sweetie, I gotta get going now. Okay. Looking forward to Christmas. Tons of hugs ahead of us. And bunches of hugs for Lady Oak, too. Okay. Bye. Bye now. My granddaughter.
Oh, she sounds adorable.
Oh, she has her grandfather wrapped around her little finger. Now, where were we?
Well, I have this marvelous new invention. It's a saposcope, and it actually allows me to hear the sap on the tree.
She's a good doctor. Pretty, too. This oak is a heart and a soul. And when she's not asleep, I seem to hear her thoughts.
Stop! You're sleeping. Shh. Quiet. Quiet.
Oh, excuse me. What do you want me to stop doing, and what tickles? But you do have a soul, a heart and a soul. I can feel it. And an amazing brain. And a sense of humor. Did you say something? Oh, I'm hearing things.
Well, the sound is a bit slow, but I'm sure she's going to be fine. She's just going to be just fine.
Oh, that's good news, Doctor.
Oh, you can call me Jan.
I'm Ozzie. What was I going to say? Oh, about my family and me.
Well, yes, I understand you're a widower, and I'm so sorry.
Oh, well, thank you. But, you know, my people people around here think my family's like a cuckoo bird, you know? And that's because of the experience that we all have with Lady Oak and how she affects how we feel when we're around her. So that's why I'm always looking for ways to make her happy.
Well, I'm feeling quite happy, but I don't think it's because of the tree.
Well, as I was saying, through the years, as I follow this tree and how she feels, I once found that she fell in love with a quaking aspen. Sadly, we lost her in a beetle pandemic. Her sap was too slow.
Well, the sap on the tree is doing okay, but I'm not so sure about this sap.
Oh, very funny. People always make fun of me.
Oh, well, I would never make fun of you, Ozzie. Especially if I thought it would make you feel bad. Mm-hmm. I'll send you my bill. You know, I truly believe that you believe. So, you might want to try telling that leafy lady a joke. Maybe it will help. Can't hurt.
A joke. It might work. I tell you what, let's do it together, Lady Oak. I'll start. Did you know my neighbor has a wooden leg? Okay, your turn.
No, but I heard his wife has a chest, has a cedar chest.
You were not funny.
What? Holy cow!
Cows are funny. Anteaters are funny. Pickleball is funny. Human history is funny. Especially Mussolini. Who's very funny.
I thought I was only hearing that stuff in my head. You're talking. I hear you. I see you. Say something.
You are a little cuckoo bird, aren't you?
And she has opinions.
Oh, I have opinions, all right. About this town and its people, Readersville, and then there's you. You who thinks I have a heart and soul. You think I sleep? I never sleep. I'm always listening. And I don't need a brain. The sap that I inherited from a forest of relatives via the migrating birds is loaded with magic. It's in the air.
Oh, happy air! I felt it! Well, why are you unhappy? And how can I help? Oh, and by the way, can everyone hear you talk now?
Just you. Oh. and mum's the word.
Mums.
Now, let's talk about my birthday and Christmas, the wonderful season of gift giving. Would you like to know what I want to make me happy? The greatest gift is this. Now write it down. I want to be made up to the nines. Glamorously beautiful. People from all over will come from miles around to see the most gorgeous 200-year-old Christmas tree.
But the townspeople have already put money up to decorate that tall fir tree. It's a gift that the people give to one another.
And what am I? Chopped liver?
Well, and it's so beautiful, it's being featured in the Town and Country magazine. But, you know, you're an oak tree, and that's not the traditional Christmas tree.
Well, I'll tell you something. I was here long before that tree ever sprouted, that leafless little squirt.
Well, the mayor will never go for it.
Oh, the mayor. To call him a bird brain would be like an insult to birds. You can convince him, Ozzy. You can do it. For me, please.
Okay. I'll bring it up at the council meeting.
Oh, what a clever idea. You are so smart.
I have no idea, but we'll find out soon.
Oh, boy. Here come the Trudy Truly. And I'll bet her sisters are right behind her. You don't want to get involved with them. They're from the wrong side of the tracks, you know.
True.
Well, I'll see you later. You know where to find me.
Just like we suspected, tell me. Tiffany's not here.
Hi, Trudy.
Hey, Tiffany.
Where's Tiffany? She ought to be here by now. She's the one that called this meeting. She sounded so excited. She must have some wonderful news.
Well, you know, Tiffany. She probably remembered something that she had to do at the last minute.
I was on my way here, and then I remembered I forgot something, so I had to go back. But anyways, I'm here. And I called you here because it's about Deke. He's coming home next week! Woo! And you'll never guess how he told me. It wasn't an email, a phone call, or even a text. It was a singing telegram. I'll be home. Christmas, you can count on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents on the tree. Speaking of presents, I'll bet you get a diamond for Christmas.
Maybe?
That Tink, he's so romantic. He's just like my hubby, who gives me a $25 gift card from Walmart every birthday.
Well, I know someone who will be so jealous when
when they see you flashing that diamond ring around. I happen to know that Ruth has been writing to him. She's had a crush on him since high school. I wouldn't put it past her if she doesn't go and try to meet him. Oh, but I'm sure it's probably you he wants.
You know what? I'm not even worried about Ruth. She doesn't stand a chance. I'm going to make Tink's homecoming so great, he won't even think to look at another woman. Going to need your help, however. I've got it. We'll tie yellow ribbons on the old oak tree.
And it's been 4 long years.
And now he's 73.
And he's coming home from the penitentiary.
Anyways, it's because of his recent incarceration and he's getting out for good behavior that maybe yellow ribbons may not be the best idea. I think...
A switchblade?
Oh, yeah. You see, Tink wanted to be safe, so before he went to jail, he gave this to me. So I'm thinking, no yellow ribbons. I'll carve a heart with our initials into the bark of this old oak tree, and it will be there forever. Now, I just have to find the right spot.
If you come one little inch in that oak tree, Ozzy will see that you take the jail cell your Tink is leaving.
Oh, I'm not worried about Ozzy. I blow him kisses, and then, ow! Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh! We'll just do the yellow ribbons and... Oh, the sheriff!
Hi, how you doing?
Hi, Sheriff. It's a lovely day. Wouldn't you say so?
Yes, but the weather can change very quickly, you know.
So true!
Just killing time until the council meeting.
Oh, that's nice!
I'm curious. Are you ladies sisters?
No, we're not even Catholic.
That's it? You call that a full report?
Well, I did mention that I thought the tree was a little down, you know, depressed.
And what was the doctor's response to that?
Well, they thought I was a loony bird, or something to that effect. But she did suggest that I tell Lady Oak a joke. So I did.
Did it work?
Well, the lady did giggle when the doctor slapped the saposcope on her. But she also said that I wasn't funny in my and then she proceeded to go on to say what was funny, which was like cows and Mussolini.
Now let me understand. Where did our oak tree get all of this information?
Migrating birds
from England.
Oh no, seagulls.
Seagulls. The tree told you all of this?
Oh yes. Mum's the word. No, it wasn't that. No, it was the doctor who told me about it. You know, she's a funny lady, you know, talking trees. Huh? That's my full
report.
Well, back to my minutes. We discussed how a certain magazine wants a picture of our beautiful Christmas tree for the cover of their November issue.
Well, as you know, we raised a lot of money and got the tall fruit tree decorated in time for their picture. We have every reason, you know, to be proud. Anything else, Alonso?
Well, we need to discuss Lady Oak's birthday.
After all, she's turning 200.
Well, did she tell you she wants a big cake with 200 candles? And, you know, she can set herself on fire with it.
Oh, please. Let me tell you something. My granddaughter called me the other day and told me that she was memorizing the poem Trees, so that when she came here for Christmas, she could recite it to Lady Oak. This tree means a lot to a lot of people. And should we neglect her, which we would be doing, it would be in travesty.
Wait a minute, that tree's is a tree, nothing but a tree. A tree doesn't know when its birthday is.
I think we should have a big celebration, though.
All right, I agree. We'll just do it in the new year.
Whoa! Her birthday is December 23rd. Why don't we have two decorated trees?
Negative. We don't want any distraction from the tree in the magazine. Case closed. Sheriff, I believe you wanted some more time.
Thank you, Mayor. In reference to your tree in the magazine, we have been notified that there is a ring of Christmas tree thieves working around here. Their MOO, method of operation, is this. They take pictures of the decorated outdoor trees, then, pretending to have a legal Christmas business, they advertise and sell the trees online. Then, in the middle of the night, they wrap the tree, saw it down, deliver it, and collect the money. Sometimes thousands of dollars.
Well, you know, I don't think we have to worry about that. I think everyone around here has chosen the tree that they want. And I have faith in you that you won't allow such a thing, Sheriff.
I think we should keep an eye out in case.
After all the money that we put in the tree, it's really our Christmas. It would be a tragedy if we lost it. Thanks for the warning, Sheriff. Is there any other business?
I really think we should celebrate Lady Oak's 200th birthday on November 23rd. After all, people come from all over the country to see her. And Christmas trees, they come and they go.
You know, Mass is right. Lady Oak is the most important tree in the world to us. And her feelings could be hurt.
Well, it's just a tree. I thought this was all settled. Meeting is adjourned.
And gorgeous and most famous Christmas tree. Yes, ma'am. I represent a company that does tree wrappings. Yes, especially the Christmas trees. Yes, what we do is we send them in on a cherry picker all the way out there. As you can see, yes, yeah.
A cherry picker?
Yes, ma'am. A cherry picker is a large frame with a humongous bucket on the top. Where we put the men inside, we shoot him up to the top, and then he wraps those feet carefully but securely. Yes, and you wonder with what? With a water-repelling material. Yes, ma'am. It is a well-protected. And what he does is starts from the very top, all the way to the bottom of the... Yes, ma'am. Yes, think how grateful your husband and the folks down can be knowing that you securely the Christmas tree, ma'am. Come on. But quickly, we must get paid now. In cash.
Well, I have $800 here.
You're a great lady. Okay, goodbye. Hello, Juan? Are you there? You won't believe what just happened. Do I have news for you? Yes, the mayor's wife was here and she looked very suspicious. You wonder why? She saw you up in the Christmas tree. Yes. Yes, and she's wondering what's happening. Yes. Hello? Hello? Hello, are you still there? But you know what? I just made a great story. And guess what? She bought it. Yes, she bought it because it's a hook, line, and sinker. Yes, she did. And guess what? She also pays in cash. What? How much? She only gave us 400. Yeah, 200 apiece. Okay, listen, don't worry about it. We're gonna make $20,000. Yes? Did you say the buyer is from Iowa? Oh, Ohio. Okay. He must have seen the picture in the cover of the magazine November. Yeah. I'm sure he did. He just had to have it. Yeah, sure. You hear that? The storm is approaching. And everyone should stay indoors inside of their homes. Yes. Listen, I got the saw in the back of my truck. Yes, what's up? Yeah, I'll be there. Right away, yeah, sure. Every time it thunders, we saw and cut the baby down. Yes! Yeah.
Yes! Yes!
Ah!
Which surprises me. Why don't you come and enjoy this beautiful morning and sit with me? With me.
You look happy. Oh, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but the mayor, I tried. I really tried. Oh, did you hear me? I tried. Oh, she doesn't seem to mind that I wasn't able to get the mayor to agree to decorate her.
Well, no one can be sad on this glorious day. Come and sit.
Oh. Not a cloud in the sky. A bit of an autumn nip in the air. Reminding us that the holidays are here.
It's a happy time. And nothing, you're right, nothing can mar this special day. Look over there. It looks like a box. Still wet from last night. It's full of yellow ribbon. I wonder who left. No! Ozzie, it's gone. Come see. It's gone.
Oh my goodness, the sheriff was right. Our beautiful tree is gone.
Mayor, come.
Christmas tree.
commission.
Yep.
are you, lady? Oh, speak to me. I miss you. I need you in my life, please.
I never thought I'd be jealous of a tree. It's a tree, Ozzy. It's just a tree. If you only cared just half as much about me.
Oh, come. Come and sit. When my wife passed, I was devastated. But then I put all of my full attention into that tree. Wonderful things did happen. It all seemed so very real to me, as if she were my surrogate partner. I felt that if I had shown my feelings toward you, it would have been as if I was being unfaithful to my wife. How sad is that? And still, I cannot deny the power that that tree has over me.
Well, thank you for your words. I wish that silly tree would work her magic and lift our spirits.
Oh, there you are, Ozzy.
Oh.
You know, you missed our last meeting.
I'm sorry. Oh, did I miss anything?
Absolutely nothing. Oh. But while I was going home, this delivery guy was coming way up from your house. And I thought you'd be here, and I thought it might be important, so I brought it to you.
Oh, well, thank you. Thank you, Marcel. And Merry Christmas.
And
whatever.
Same to you.
It looks like a Christmas present.
Oh, I think I know where this is from.
I have scissors in my purse. I always come prepared.
Oh, she's unhappy because everyone is so sad here for Christmas, and nobody wants to come here for Christmas. Dear Grandpa, you told me that Lady Oak Tree is not well. Why don't you decorate her and make her your Christmas tree? Then you will have Christmas tree again. I'm sending this ornament. Oh, she couldn't spell it. She's sending some pretty things to put on her. Please do this for me. Love, Gabby.
I'm in the mouths of babes.
I'll hang it.
Oh.
Thank you. Oh, Ozzy, I suddenly feel so much better, and the tree seems to be doing better. Isn't that amazing?
Yes.
Well, hand me another bottle. You know, there's something magical about these ornaments.
Oh, there's something magical about that wise old oak tree.
So what do you think we've learned from all this?
Oh, the greatest thing we've ever learned, will ever learn, is just to love and to be loved in return.
That would make some nice lyrics in a song. Do you think we can live up to that?
Yes, we can.
Yes, we can. I've got some more decorations at home. I'll be right back.
Oh, is that a tear I see?
Yes, but it's a tear of joy, knowing that even an old, majestic oak can overcome any jealousy and be forgiven. Now, every person that comes into this square will get a whiff of these bubbles. And then watch what happens. Woo-hoo! Well, it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Everywhere you go. Oh, and I'll go anywhere with you, Ozzy. Yeah.
Oh, there you are. I've been looking all over for you. Why are you looking so happy?
It's something in the air. Take a sniff.
Breathe.
Wow! Oh! I feel 50 years younger!
Enjoy yourself.
Enjoy yourself. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
I know you can hear me. You see, I'm a believer that you're more than just a tree. So on December 23, we will have a jubilee. And the townspeople will come and decorate you to the nines with baubles and bangles that sparkle and shine. Hey, Owen didn't even know it. Do you townspeople need some help decorating?
Well, I must say, folks, I've never felt so beautiful. Are you? Oh, you're working so hard. Thank you so much. Beautiful. What beautiful ornaments that are falling from the sky. Okay. What about that one? Let's see. Got to get that one up there. These things don't last forever. They were made in China. So anyway, back to the story. Well, I must say, folks, that I've never felt so beautiful. I'm humbled to think that the fifth generation of folks that I have watched come and go still wants to honor me. But deep inside of me, I think that we should be honoring little Gabby, who saw what the rest of us couldn't see, because our eyes were either closed or looking at the ground. When she recites Kilmer's poem, Trees, it will have a new meaning. And folks, Ozzy and I had a heart-to-heart, and, well, yes, I have one. I told him that he has made me totally happy just seeing him with Jan, so he can move on. But first, I hear people arriving. I think they need closure. Let's watch.
Mr. Mayor, Tiffany wants to talk to you about what her awful, bad, evil
Well, come here. Come closer. Now, watch me. This will make you so much happier. So, go like this. And sniff.
From now on, I promise you to be worthy of you.
And I'll start by giving you a Christmas gift to you now.
Wow!
And don't lose it, cost me a lot.
It's gorgeous!
It's beautiful. I have to show everyone.
Going to line! One, two, three, the come down! One, two, three, the come down! One, two, three, the come down!
Everyone is having a ball. Isn't it amazing how contagious joy can be? Joy follows love, and love follows joy. This Christmas, it is so very important that we remember the words of the one whose birth we celebrate. He said, "As I have loved you, love one another." We can begin to heal this planet if we reach out with love to the family of the world. As Lady Oak, I am humbled and honored that so many of you came to experience our story. Thank you. Now Ruth will present our cast. The city's mayor was played by Gary Payne. And Katie Parker played Marcel, his wife. The Clogger and friend to the sheriff was played by Jim Roberts. And the sheriff was played by Sandy Handlong Kressler. The three sisters, Trudy Truly, played by Anita Laws, Kelly Truly, played by Kathy Taylor Linford, and Kathy Truly, played by Becky Wagner. Guy Chief was played by Mario. Jan, the tree doctor, who gave loving aid to the tree, and Ozzy was played by Karen Lemon. Ozzy Draw, the tree whisperer, was played by Mike Corcoran. That Elvis really was in the house?
Yeah.
A special thanks to Kevin Conley for his cameo appearance. And now I'd like you to meet Lady Oak, Ann and Carol. Thank you. I have some people to thank also. I have to thank Jan Dorchery, Lila Emmer, and Katie Corker for their work behind the scenes. The designer artist for our beautiful backdrop, and Aunt Nancy Beck, the head painter. Thank you to the many volunteers who helped in many ways. Their names are on the playbill. A special thanks goes to Jim Robertson and Clay Hossett and to Dean Carlston for constructing backdrops. They were on their knees.
Anyways, they transported them back and forth and back and forth from one garage to another and to the community center and back. Many people helped with it, but they are real he-men. Peggy Schneider, sitting next to me, she kept you informed of Lady Oak's rehab in the Friday email. And as an assistant director, her insights for improving our performances made for a better show. Lady Oak could not have been created without the collaboration of my friend Ruth Handley. Woo-hoo! The two of us worked hand in hand, shopping and bouncing ideas back and forth and creating our Lady Oak. Lady Oak had no voice until Claire Wilsey breathed life into her. With so much love and joy, she directed the cast and accompanied us. If you'll wait just a second, then we can present her.
Yeah,
okay. With so much love and joy, she directed her cast. Well, that gummit goes. They take them and they come and get them and they take them. Sounds like Jim and Dean. Yeah. Anyways, she has an amazing repertoire. Who knows what other great scripts are lurking in her beautiful head. It's time.
First of all, giving these to Peggy, who really was the arms and legs of Claire.
And the legs.
Did everything. And Claire wrote and directed this play, which will most likely be the last one that she will write and direct. We appreciate that she has been part of our theater groups for so long. She is so wonderful. We love you, Claire.
We love you. Well, when Claire's hands are off the flowers and back on the keys, maybe we can all sing a song together. How about White Christmas? If you would like to sing with us, or we would like you to sing with us.
Yes, I know.
Something like that. Okay.
Oh.
minute. We would like to congregate in the hallway so we can talk to you as you come out. So give us a minute to get there because we'd like to show you how much we've appreciated you as an audience.